Alright guys, long time no see. As you can see, we got a new tank. Got rid of the stupid bio cube. It's too small. Couldn't get any more room out of it, so. Here's my new 20-gallon long. It is a Nano Reef. It's got, I'm gonna go through the corals, fish, and then I'm gonna show you down to my equipment. Well, first fish, of course, clownfish. Everyone loves them. My black misbar, Basilaris clown. My last tank, doing really well. And recently got a mate. It's a Part B Picasso clown. It's not one of them stupid, just, you know, regular Ocellaris clowns. And as you may have seen, I'm not quite sure where he went. I have a striped daddy back. He, he just kind of ran into the back. There he goes. Caught him. But that's my fish, basically. And I have a green mandarin, but, he's not doing so hot, and he's kind of hard to find. He's actually right there in the corner. Right there. You can, as you can see, that white mark on his fin. It's like a bacterial infection or something like that. And it's actually eating away at his fin, and his fin's like slowly deteriorating. So, yeah. Well, those are my fish so far. What? Start with the corals. There's my yellow leather toadstool. My other toadstool. That's just my small one. She's still doing good. Got that a couple months ago. And my SPS corals. I have a Montipora Cappy. I have two different species of bird's nest. I forget which both species they are, but yeah. There's a little frag of that mother colony. Montipora digitata doing well. And my sea bay anemone. Of course. I got a little rock of zoo amphibs. And frog spawn. Awesome. Got a lot bigger. And my turbinaria, which my Picasso hosts in for some reason. And it never shows a polyp, so yeah. And my pulsing zinnia, which is now is kind of getting beat up just because I moved it around like 3 times today. So kind of see it pulsing. It's too much flow for it though. I'm gonna go down. My little frag of Montipora digitata. Doing pretty good. Starting to branch out top. And my giant torch coral, which is doing amazing. My last tank needed some more room because it's taking up this whole corner. So, yeah. And I can't forget my clam. Doing awesome. And, with the equipment. I got a little Coralia 1, I think it is, in my main flow. And on my return pump, I have a water deflector. And then over there, I have a little Coralia Nano there, just to get all the dirt from sticking in the corners. So. And my overflow box, it's a CPR. Now, of course, the aqua lifter, which you always need. It goes down to my sump. And it first flows into that one chamber with the PVC pipe. Goes through a sock and then through a nitrate sponge and phosphate remover. And then goes to my refugium, my Calorchis and Zeta morphology, my little bit of live sand and live rock, my light torch, my remora, and some breaking sliver. Flows over to my return pump. Goes back to the tank. And there's my little 1 gallon jug of bad water. And for lighting, we got a little PC Coral Life compact fluorescence. It's like 6 watts per gallon, so that's why the SPS corals are doing so good. But yeah, if you guys got any questions, just let me know. I'll get back to you. Tell me what you think and post some comments.